Christine Chang, how do you plead?
At this time, Your Honor.
Excuse me, Your Honor. Mark Sullivan, Southern District of New York. I have an arrest warrant for Christine Chang on federal charges.
Approach?
Objection, Your Honor. We had no knowledge of this.
We have a plea deal in place.
Not anymore. This case has international implications. We've requested the suspension of the state's case to investigate and prosecute with global disposition. The DA has agreed to allow us to take the lead on this.
Your Honor, this is...
It's out of my hands, Mr. Carisi. The state's case is hereby suspended. I am releasing Christine Chang to federal custody. Bailiff.
Bailiff, next time, Counselor.
What the hell was that? The feds can't just waltz in here and take our case.
They can. They did. Evidently, my boss has signed off on it. The Changs cut a backdoor deal with the DOJ.
No, we had them. International sex trafficking, money laundering.
They trumped that. National security, intel on China, whatever it is, we'll never know. That's why she confessed so easily. She had this in her back pocket.
I don't think so. Her confession was sincere.
Either way, it never happened.
So what? Forget it, Jake? It's Chinatown? Did you know this was coming?
No. I give you my word. The DA didn't even give me the courtesy of a heads up. I'm sorry.
Lock this predator up and throw away the key. I pray what he did to my daughters, he doesn't do to anyone else.
Thank you, Mr. Bucci, for your moving words. That being said, many aspects of this case give me pause. The defendant had no way of knowing Ivy Bucci's age. She provided a fake ID.
Ignorance of age is no excuse under the law, Your Honor.
She was paid thousands of dollars, along with being gifted cell phones, designer clothing, an Uber account.
Your Honor, we've agreed to a plea.
And I'm revisiting that plea. After reviewing the case file, I don't see criminal sexual acts here.
Oh my.
I see consensual sexual activity.
Again, Your Honor, she's under the age of consent.
What? She's just a kid, Your Honor. He raped her.
Right.
Enough, Mr. Bucci. I don't want to hold you in contempt. This girl made her own choice. If a 15-year-old has the constitutional right to an abortion without parental approval, how should she not also have the constitutional right to consensual sex? I'm dismissing the top charges of rape and forcible touching. The case can move forward on the prostitution charge.
We plead guilty to that, Your Honor.
The DA's office strongly objects.
And your objection is on the record. Mr. Goetz, I sentence you to time served. You're free to go.
I didn't rape her. I just paid her for consensual sex.
Thank you, Mr. Ryan.
Now, it was your idea to go into this champagne room that night, wasn't it?
Yes, but she wanted to.
How'd you know that?
Come on, she's a stripper. I mean, I'm a celebrity. They all want a piece of me.
I get it. It's actually why I'm kind of surprised that you had to pay for sex.
I didn't have to. Just trying to keep it simple. Avoid the drama. These free-range women, they just love...
You mean the women who you don't pay for, who are free to say no?
You know how it is. One way or another, you always end up paying for it.
And these women, let's face it, they always want something.
Yeah, they're all smiles and eyelashes, all Markievicz this, Markievicz that. They just want to rub up on me. You know, get some of that glow, some of that money.
So you've had other women come after your money before?
All the time. Ask my ex-wife. She'll tell you all the lawsuits I've had to fight.
But the lawsuits? For what? Raping women?
Objection.
Your client opened the door.
I didn't rape these women, but they see me as their golden ticket. The guy who pays the bills. Smiles for their dumbass selfies.
So you do all the work, and these women, they just take, and they take.
Objection.
Overruled.
What am I? Am I every bitch's charity?
Right, they take, and they take, and what do they give you?
The only thing they got
Sex.
What else do they have that I want?
Yeah, but what if they don't give you that?
Doesn't happen. Nobody says no to Marquis.
Yeah, but what if they do? What if they get the nerve to say no to you?
That just means they want more money.
Because you're Marquis Ryan, and every woman wants a piece.
Damn right.
Objection, Your Honor.
Overruled.
No further questions.
You okay?
Not really, no. Jerry's been out for days.
It's been 3 hours, Chris. Did you just throw up?
No. Yeah. Well, I mean, for the verdict, it's different when it's your case.
Let's take a walk.
Well, hold that thought. Jerry's coming back.
Okay.
No, I'm good. I'm good.
On the sole count of rape in the first degree, how does the jury find?
We find the defendant, Marquis Ryan, guilty.
Prosecution intends to call Maggie Quigley and Rosamie Klein.
Your Honor, this is the first we're hearing of these witnesses. I need time to prepare. I request an adjournment for the day.
So granted.
Where the hell did you pull these two out of?
Baggy of Klein's fan. My guess, he's not going to hear their testimony in open court. See O'Toole's face? He's going to fold.
Make it hurt.
My client had a long, dark night of the soul to think about this.
Well, it's not a whole lot to think about. It's all over but the hard time, O'Toole.
Back up. Hold on a second.
No, I'm done waiting. Tomorrow, Rosamie and Maggie are gonna take the stand, but before they do, we're gonna bump the charges from rape 3 to rape 1. And when they're done testifying, the jury and your client will be in tears.
Let's show a little compassion for a fellow officer. Counselor?
Well, the same compassion that he showed his victims.
I was doing my job. I've been serving my country on the front lines of a foreign invasion for 20 years.
Serving your country? By dipping your wick?
It was a test. It's the only way to know if they really love their husbands.
Okay. Now, you told me before that if they really loved their husbands, they wouldn't sleep with you.
That's right.
But when they refused you, you threw them in jail. And if they did sleep with you, you gave them their green card. Now, you can lie to yourself all you want, but you raped these women.
No, absolutely not. I was just doing what I had to do to protect our borders.
Rory, he understands.
No, he doesn't understand it. I'm holding the line between more mouths to feed, more people on Medicaid, in our public schools, in our hospitals, okay? Taking our jobs. These people are bleeding the system dry, and I stopped that from happening. I stopped that.
Now one more word from you. What you did to these women, how many of them have had to live with your violation in secret, in fear? You took advantage of them when they were the most helpless, the most vulnerable, and you used the power of your government position to force them to demean themselves. They came here hoping for the American dream, and you made their lives a nightmare. I'm sick of your clan, Counselor. You want to talk deal? He needs to shut his mouth and nod yes. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
Folks, that was a false start. Bear with us. I'll ask you again, Counselor Barth. Where's your client?
Your Honor, I have some bad news. I just heard from Sir Toby's wife that en route to the courthouse, he suffered a heart episode and is being rushed to Mount Sinai.
Your Honor, we just put a jury together. I have witnesses who have been standing by for months, waiting.
I'm sorry if my client's heart attack is inconvenient for the prosecutor.
So it's a heart attack now? Because 10 seconds ago, it was an episode.
Counselor!
He's just arrived at ICU. They'll be doing testing. His cardiologist is meeting him
All
there.
All due respect to Mr. Moore's cardiologist, but I feel it is highly coincidental that the morning we are finally starting this trial, Mr. Moore once again suffers an episode.
Mr. Carisi, if this is a ruse, the court will respond.
You said it yourself. If need be, he should be brought in here on a stretcher. He's showing contempt for this court and you,
Your Honor. The only one showing contempt is Mr. Carisi.
Your client's afraid to have the women he raped confront him in open court.
It's enough, Mr. Carisi, not one more word. Now, I'll grant another postponement, but your client better be on death's door. We're adjourned.
He already has.
I saw my son about to give up his life for me. I couldn't let that happen. I took the dryer out of his hand. Dwight had that look, and I knew if I didn't stop him, there was gonna be hell to pay. I threw the dryer in. My son was just trying to protect me. I'm the one who should have been protecting him.
Counselor.
Your Honor, given the traumatic circumstances, the state has no interest in pursuing charges against Will Vargas, and we will accept a guilty plea of criminally negligent homicide from Ms. Nowak.
And how do you plead, Ms. Nowak?
I'm guilty, Your Honor.
Having reviewed all of the evidence, I accept the guilty verdict and sentence Ms. Nowak to a year in prison. On the condition that she and her family start getting psychological help.
A year? A year? That's all?
Ma'am, calm down, please.
What? She killed him! She killed the father of my baby! You killed him! You killed my Dwight! You killed my husband! No!
Are you ready to allocute, Judge Gallagher?
I am. Today, I plead guilty to sexual misconduct. What I thought was consensual, I now understand was perceived as coercive and hurtful actions.
I understand there's a deal.
We've agreed to the DA's offer of 1 year to be served under house arrest.
Mr. Carisi, are you comfortable with this?
My office is satisfied, Your Honor.
Well, I'm not. Judge Gallagher, you come from a good family, a fine home. And yet, despite all those advantages upon achieving power, you abused it habitually. So in the interest of true justice for the women you've abused, I hereby order you to serve your 1 year sentence in a jail cell.
What?
It's fine.
You can't do that. We had a deal.
You did. And as you well understand, the bench has inherent powers in these situations. The long arm of the law can work both ways. You're remanded. Take Mr. Gallagher into custody.
It's fine. Don't worry. I will be in touch shortly.